This lecture is regarding the principal stresses and principal planes. The normal stress and shear stress varies with the angle of inclination of the plane in an element. So if I consider a biaxial and shear stress condition, the element will be acted by two tensile stresses. One is in the direction of x, that is sigma x. Another is in direction y, that is sigma y. Along with this, the shear stress will also act on the element. Now, if I want to analyze the stress on the plane that is making angle theta with normal, and this theta is in clockwise direction, consider this as plane RS. For making this problem a 2D problem, I consider the thickness of this element as 1 unit. So I can transform it into a two-dimensional figure in which this is my vertical plane and the plane under consideration, that is RS, is making angle theta in the clockwise direction. I can also mark the stresses acting on this triangular element. Now on this plane RS, there will be two stresses mutually perpendicular, that is sigma theta, and the tangential one I name it as tau theta. So we can resolve all the forces on this triangular element, and with the help of the equation of equilibrium, I can easily find the relation for sigma theta, that is a normal stress on the plane RS, that will be given by 1 by 2 sigma x plus sigma y plus 1 by 2 sigma x minus sigma y cos 2 theta plus tau sine 2 theta. And also the tangential stress will be given by 1 by 2, that will be negative. Negative means it is a anti-clockwise shear. So what I assumed here is a clockwise shear stress, but what I am getting is negative, that means it is acting in the opposite direction. So it will be given by minus 1 by 2 sigma x minus sigma y sine 2 theta plus tau cos 2 theta. So these are two important equations, 1 and 2, that gives me the normal stress and shear stress on the plane. So now if I want to find out the plane on which sigma theta is maximum or minimum, I have to differentiate sigma theta with respect to theta. So if I differentiate the equation number 1, I will get 0 minus 1 by 2 sigma x minus sigma y. Differentiation of cos 2 theta is minus 2 sine 2 theta, plus and differentiation of sine 2 theta is 2 times cos 2 theta. So this is what I get, and equated to 0, I get tan 2 theta is equal to 2 tau sigma x minus sigma y. So this equation provides that there are two values of 2 theta for which The direct stress have the maximum and minimum values, and that 2 theta will be differing by the angle 180 degree. That means theta will be differing by 90 degrees. So that means they are two mutual perpendicular planes. So from equation 2, if I want to find out the planes where shear stress is 0, then I will again get tan 2 theta is equal to 2 tau sigma x minus sigma y. So this means that the planes on which sigma theta is maximum or minimum will have zero shear stress. So it can be concluded that shear stresses are zero on the planes with maximum or minimum values of direct stress, and these planes are called principal planes, and the corresponding stress on these planes is called principal stresses. So the new terms here are principal plane. So in two-dimensional problem, there exist two planes that are mutually perpendicular to each other, where sigma theta will be maximum or minimum, and tau theta will be zero. So this maximum or minimum normal stress is called principal stress. So on one principal plane, this normal stress will be sigma 1, and on another will be sigma 2. So we consider that sigma 1 is greater than sigma 2. So the one which is greater is called major principal stress, and the one which is smaller is called minor principal stress. So we are considering the two-dimensional element, so we consider the third principal stress as zero. Otherwise, in three-dimensional element, there exist three mutually perpendicular planes on which we have three principal stresses, sigma 1, sigma 2, and sigma 3. If I want to find out the value of sigma 1 and sigma 2, I have to put the value of 2 theta, that is for the position of principal plane. So the position of principal plane is given by this equation, that is tan 2 theta is equal to 2 tau by sigma x minus sigma y. So if I draw a triangle and I consider this as 2 theta, so according to tan 2 theta, I can write this triangle, the sides of this triangle as 2 tau and sigma x minus sigma y. This is the hypotenuse, that's why I can write this side as sigma x minus sigma y square plus 2 times tau square 1 by 2. So from here I can say that sine 2 theta is plus minus 2 tau divided by, this is the pure trigonometry, sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 tau square, and cos 2 theta is given by plus minus sigma x minus sigma y divided by sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau square. So when I put the values of cos 2 theta and sin 2 theta in the equation for normal stress, that is equation number 1, so I get sigma, now it is sigma theta is equal to principal stresses 1 and 2 is given by 1 by 2 sigma x plus sigma y plus minus 1 by 2 sigma x minus sigma y square divided by root of sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 tau square plus minus 2 tau square divided by sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 tau square. So after simplifying it, I will get that principal stresses 1 and 2 are equal to 1 by 2 sigma x plus sigma y plus minus 1 by 2 root of sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 tau square. So this is the equation for principal stresses. So concluding the topic, I can state that sigma 1 and sigma 2 are the principal stresses. Sigma 1 is major principal stress, sigma 2 is minor principal stress, and their value is given by this important equation, and the position of principal planes is given by tan 2 theta is equal to 2 tau by sigma x minus sigma y. So these are two important equations about principal planes.